It's not that bad. No. See? Yeah. I hate my. Lord help them hear me and make clear my voice. Cause being
gay is nothing but a choice. I'm Aston Bully, MTV News webcam correspondent, delivering to you news from the online social scene. Now here in the online world, we like nothing more than controversy. Sometimes too fake to be real, sometimes too real to be fake. These anonymous videos stir up the blogosphere with one simple question. Is it real or not?
Hi, we're the girls from the Wig Out video.
We're sisters, they're friends, and she really did cut her hair.
These past few weeks brought us not one, but two of these online hoaxes. A bride who literally wigs out on her wedding day, and an evangelical pastor who, well...
Everyone here knows I'm a reformed homosexual. We're gonna release the CHOPS program, which is gonna help everybody out. CHOPS is changing homosexuals into ordinary people.
Now for some of us, the telltale sign said it all. Giggling girls enamored with the camera, a rotund man with a mustache, a list of gay bans and safe bans. I mean, how could it be real? For the rest of us, the bloggers emerged, smoking out Wig Out Girl faster than you can say Dan Rather, linking to her picture on her Facebook profile. Donnie Davies proved to be a tougher find. His true identity was mistaken, twice, before finally being linked to Dallas-based actor Joey Oglesby. Even now, some still wonder just who Donnie Davies is. Well, we contacted the crew responsible for unleashing Donnie and his fictional Love God's Way organization, and yes, it is fake. But in characteristic fashion, Donnie, aka Joey and his crew, shared with us some of the lessons they've learned.
As a filmmaker, I wanted to bring Donnie's message to a lot of people and let everybody make up their minds about it.
What I thought would happen, when y'all shot the video and I was helping edit the video and all that kind of stuff, I thought everyone was going to laugh at this guy. I mean, the guy's obviously gay.
Yeah.
And the fact that he wore this pink shirt and a mustache, I thought there's no way anyone's going to take him seriously. So I think universally we were surprised with how seriously people took him.
I thought it was interesting how everybody that was on the gay ban list mostly wanted to get off the gay ban list, but then almost everyone on MySpace wanted to get on the gay ban list.
Yeah. Everybody wanted their bans. I definitely have about 4,000 emails with people wanting their bans to be on the gay bans list.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Toppy.
Some people chastised him, but some people like thought he was this incredible like hate monger and stuff like that. I don't know. I just always found him very humorous.
It's such a bizarre message, and I think everybody really got that, even if they didn't realize it, even if they were angry about it. They realize the absurdity of the message.
Donnie Davies.
It's a learning from them.
Now, if you were fooled by Donnie this time, remember the rule of online hoaxes for next time. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on you. You can't be fooled again. If you have any online videos or websites to share, you could reach me here. And now, enjoy this random online moment.
Welcome back to Hannity and Combs. I'm Chuck Norris filling in for Sean Hannity.